my channel. So today we are going to talk about social casework. Okay, so we all know that as an individual we are living into a society and we also called as social animal, or we can say that social being. So since we are living into a society, we used to make social relationship between each other. So as long as our social relationship goes smoothly, it has also a positive effect on social order. But if our social relation is not going properly, or we can say some obstacle happened in our social relationship, it will also affect our social order, which means a negative effect can be on social order, and that will affect our smooth functioning of our society as well. So social work used to study about the social relationship and the problems which is happening in a social relationship. So social work as a discipline used to understand this human relationship problem, or we can say that human problem, and used to give some solution for solving this human problem. And the method which used to solve this human problem is known as social casework. I already discussed about different methods, I mean primary method and secondary method of social work in my first video. If you are very first time to my video, please go and watch my first video to understand the basics of social work. Okay, so social casework is known as the primary method of social work, which is actually helping to understand human problem and also giving some solution to solve this particular human problem. And it is not only helping to solve human problem, whereas it is also helping individual to equip different skill to solve their future problem without any support of externals. So the major milestone of social casework as a method of social work was the publication of Social Diagnosis by Mary Richmond in 1917. So she defined social casework as: social casework is the art of bringing adjustment in social relationship in men, women and children. So I think before talking about social casework very detailed, we need to know the basics of social casework and what actually making problems in a human relationship. So if we are unable to know about this, we cannot understand what is actually the problem of a human being. For conducting a psychosocial studies, the social worker used it to focus on the mainly three concepts, or we can say that a basic concept to understand it. So now we can check that three basic concept and what all are that basic concept to understand or making these psychosocial studies. So first one is social role. I think I already discussed about social role and what all are the problems can be happened in a social role in my previous video. So I'm not going to explain it very detailed. So as we all know that as a human being, we are into a different institution, or we can say that social institution. So as a human being, we need to perform our duties of, or we can say that our roles in different social institutions. Say for example, if I am into my home or family, I need to perform the duty of a doctor. And if I am going my educational institution, I need to perform the duty of a teacher. And if I am going an institution called marriage, I need to perform the duty of a wife. So sometimes the individual are unable to perform this duty not properly, or we can say that we are not equipped properly with the skills to perform these particular roles in a different situation. So since we need to change our roles in different institutions, there can be a problem if we are unable to equip proper skill, or if you don't know how we need to perform this role properly, there can be a problems in our human relationship, or we can say that in a individual. So social worker used to, when they are making a psychosocial analysis, they used to focus on to this particular concept to understand what is the actual problem of a human being. The second concept is known as ego. So as we all know that ego is actually the moderator of id and superego. So id actually having complete role in a human being's to understand the reality, or to adapt some situation, or we can say that to moderate this id and ego. Sometimes if a person's ego is not developed properly, they faces many problems to solve some problems in their life, or we can say that they are unable to adapt the situation. So in this case, social worker has the complete role to strengthen their ego for the present need as well as future needs. And the third concept, or we can say that is the last basic concept of a social casework, is considered as adaptation. So as an individual, we are expect to face new situation, or we can say that new roles. So sometimes if you are moving to face a new situation or new roles, we feel more anxiety, more tension, and we feel more, what we can say, that we are unable to cope up with that particular situation. So in this case, as an individual, we use it to depend upon to the social caseworker for finding out the solution. So there are certain objectives for social casework. Now we can check what are the objectives of social casework. So the first objective, to understand and solve the internal problems of individual. And second one, to prevent the problems in social functioning of the client. Third objective, to develop resource to enhance social functioning of individuals in problem. And last one, to strengthen individual's self-esteem. These all are the major objective of social casework. So now we need to check about the principle of social casework. So I already discussed many principles of social work in my first video. In this video or in this principle, I need to add some more concept. Now we can check the principle of social casework. So the first principle of social casework is considered as the principle of individualization. So which says that the primary task of a social caseworker is to recognize, understand and acknowledge each client as unique, to comprehend each client's problem as different from the other client. So role of a social caseworker. First one, social caseworker should have the basic knowledge of human nature. And second one, social caseworker should be able to empathize with client. Third one, social caseworker should be unbiased. And last one, social caseworker should be able to listen and observe the mannerism of the client. So the second principle is called as the principle of purposeful expression of feelings. And one of the major role of social caseworker is to enable ventilation and expression of feelings of the client. And the social caseworker must therefore act as a mediator for relieving the pressure and tension of the client. When a client expresses feeling, they develop a certain attachment with social caseworker. And this is often called as transference. Third principle, principle of acceptance. So in the year 1932, the word accept was understood as understanding the client as he or she is and to respect the integrity of client. And in 1947, the word acceptance was widely used to describe the attitude of social caseworker towards his or her client. And in the year 1950, the word accept was described as taking an individual as he or she is and with all his or her limitations. There are three steps of acceptance. First one, perceiving. The client must be accepted by the workers as he or she is, including strength and weakness, positive and negative quality as it is. Second one, therapeutic understanding. Social caseworker must see the object of acceptance in relation to the problem that are being faced and why the problem have happened in the first place. Okay. And this has to be done for the better understanding of the problem of the client and establishment of better therapeutic goal. And third one, acknowledging it as a pertinent reality and helping the client to come to term with his or her own reality and deal effectively with problems. And the fourth principle is principle of controlled emotional involvement. This principle guides social casework professional not to indulge too much personally in the client's difficult situation or being too objective. Therefore, the social caseworker should maintain a reasonable emotional distance even while sympathizing with the client. Social worker should indicate the understanding of the difficult situation of the client without showing pity or appearing to be indifferent. And fifth one, the principle of non-judgmental attitude. Principle of non-judgmental attitude presumes that the social caseworker should begin the professional relationship without any bias. He should not form opinion about the client, good or bad, worthy or unworthy. He has to treat the client as somebody who has come to him for help, and he should be willing to help the client without being influenced by the opinion of others about the client's or his situation. This enables the worker and the client feel free to develop understanding of each other. Sixth one, principle of self-determination. And this principle emphasizes client's right to self-determination. Every individual's client has the right to decide what is appropriate for him and decide the way and means to realize it. In other words, social caseworker should not force decision or solution on the client because the client has come to him for help.
Therefore, social caseworker should support and guide the client to develop insight into his social situation in correct perspective and encourage and involve him to like decisions that are good and acceptable to him. Last principle, principle of confidentiality. Social casework believe that during the professional help between the client and social caseworker, client have the right of personal information about themselves in relation with a social agency. And the principle believe that confidential things of the client must be kept confidential and other agencies and individual and should be consulted only with the client consent.
So thank you so much for watching, and for the next class I will explain about the process of social casework. And if you have any doubt or if you need some concept very detailed, please comment in this video below. I will try to explain the concept very detailed.